માં સ્વામીની પ્રેરણા સર્વથી સ્વભણી ત્રિભાષ્ય સામયિક મલ્ટીલિંગ્વલ બાય મંથલી માર્ચ એપ્રિલ 2023 વોલ્યુમ નંબર 3 ઇશ્યુ નંબર 13 સાક્ષીભાવની શક્તિ સાક્ષીભાવ કી શક્તિ ધ પાવર ઓફ ઇક્વેનિમિટી
Attainment of peace, equanimity. Sadhika, Dr. Amrit Prajna. Equanimity is a concept that has been discussed and practiced for thousands of years. It is a state of being that is characterized by calmness, composure, and balance in the face of life's challenges. Samay, Dhamma Mudahare. Samay, equanimity. Called as religion. It means the root of religion is equanimity, samatha. The origin of the word samatha is sama, means equal. Literally means evenness, alikeness, similarity and equality. This translated into English in various ways, such as an observance of equanimity. Viewing all living beings as one's own self, conception of equality, harmonious state of one's behavior, integration of personality, as well as righteousness of the activities of mind. In general, the word equanimity means a tensionless state of consciousness or state of self-absorption. In its general sense, this means a particular religious practice through which one can attain equanimity of mind. It is a state in which self is completely free from the flickering of alternative desires and wishes, excitements and emotional disorders. It is a state in which one is completely free from attachments and aversion. It is the ability to remain centered and balanced even in the face of difficult emotions, situations, or circumstances. It is the ability to maintain a sense of inner peace and serenity in the midst of chaos and turmoil. Equanimity is a quality that can be developed through meditation and mindfulness practices. By cultivating a deeper awareness of our thoughts, emotions, and sensations, we can learn to observe them with detachment and without judgment. This allows us to gain a greater sense of perspective and to respond to life's challenges with greater wisdom and compassion. Equanimity can also be cultivated through the development of positive qualities such as loving kindness, compassion, and joy. By learning to cultivate these qualities within ourselves, we are better able to extend them to others and to the world around us. This creates a virtuous cycle in which our inner peace and equanimity is strengthened, and we become better able to serve others with compassion and kindness. One of the benefits of equanimity is that it can help us to overcome our fears and anxieties. By cultivating a sense of inner calm and balance, we are better able to face the challenges of life with greater courage and resilience. Equanimity can also help us to develop a greater sense of self-awareness and self-mastery as we learn to observe our thoughts and emotions without being controlled by them. Equanimity, Samayika, is the principal concept of Jainism. It is the first foremost among six essential duties of a monk as well as of a householder. One who, by giving up the movement of uttering words, realized himself with non-attachment is said to have supreme equanimity. One who behaves equally as one's own self towards all living beings, mobile and immobile, is said to have equanimity, Further, it is said that one who observes self-control, vows and austerities, one in whom attachments and aversion do not cause any disturbance or tension, and one who always refrains from indulgence, sorrow and ennui, it is said to have attained equanimity. Jainism emphasizes great importance to the state of equanimity. This practice of equanimity is equated with religion itself. In Acharang, it is said that all the worthy people preach religion as equanimity. Thus, for Jains, the observance of religious life is nothing but the practice for the attainment of equanimity. According to them, it is the essence of all types of religious activities, and they all are prescribed only to attain it. Not only in Jainism, but in Hinduism also, we find various references in support of equanimity. The term is often used in Buddhism, where it is considered to be one of the four Brahma Viharas or the four divine abodes. Gita defines yoga as equanimity. Similarly, in Bhagavati, it is said that the observance of equanimity is worship of Lord. Jain religious texts says that one who observes hard penance and austerities, such as eating once in a month or two, as well as one who makes the donations of crores of golden coins every day, cannot attain emancipation unless he attains equanimity. It is only through the attainment of equanimity of mind that one can get emancipation or liberation. In conclusion, equanimity is a powerful quality that can help us to navigate the challenges of life with greater ease and grace. By cultivating a deeper sense of inner peace and balance, we are better able to respond to life's ups and downs with wisdom and compassion. Through mindfulness practices, positive qualities, and self-awareness, we can learn to cultivate this quality within ourselves and to share it with others.